Hi viewers, Jackie Dresser here with the Lake Erie Regional Grape Program on an exceptionally warm day in February in the Lake Erie region. Despite the nice temperatures now, back in January around the 14th, we saw the coldest winter temperatures of the year, and depending on where you were in the region, temperatures went anywhere from above zero to 16 below. So we have some resources on the LERGP.com website that show the low temperature tracking all the way through the month of December and January. So if you're curious, just find your weather station on that page and you can take a look. What we're looking for today, we're sampling to take a look at any bud injury that might have occurred on that cold event. We're taking some samples of Riesling, and it's important when you're sampling, especially in this block, though it's very small, there's quite a bit of variation in vine size, in wood maturity, that sort of thing. And that's gonna impact how the buds developed in the growing season last year. So we wanna make sure we're taking a representative sample. You don't just wanna pick your healthiest, strongest vines, and you certainly don't wanna pick just your weakest vines either. Typically, 100 buds is a nice sample number. It just kinda makes the math really easy. So picking a nice established cane, that would be a good candidate for saving. You have a 10 bud cane, and that's going to give you a good idea of how you made it through the year. And we'll take these inside and we'll be able to dissect them. So we're gonna grab the rest of our samples and we'll meet you in the lab. We'll start actually cutting into these buds and taking a look at what kind of mortality we saw from that cold event this year. So see you in there. Here we are in the lab, and we have our samples that we collected. You really want to make sure that they've been soaking in water at room temperature. 2 days is probably good. You want to give time for the tissue that is dead to oxidize and kind of make it easier to actually dissect the buds. So we'll grab one of our canes here. Nice sharp razor blade is important. It's pretty crucial to take conservative cuts. So you want to take, maybe 5 cuts. Just a little tiny slice off the top and then kind of go a little bit deeper. So on the first cut, we're not really exposing much, but that's good because you don't want to go too deep because you only get one shot at it really. And each bud is going to have a primary bud, which I'm just starting to see, a secondary bud, and a tertiary bud, which tends to be a little bit more difficult to locate. The primary bud, if it's alive, which at first glance here, I'm seeing nice green tissue on the primary bud, which is what we want to see. So the primary bud here is nice and green. The secondary bud is nice and green, and I'm just going to keep kind of slicing away till I can get the tertiary. And they all look very happy on this bud. So a primary bud is going to have a full crop on it. If the primary bud is dead and the secondary bud is still alive, anecdotally, it's about a third crop potential on the secondary bud. And if both the primary and secondary are dead, but you still have a tertiary, the tertiary is not going to produce a crop, but it can still be, really crucial in keeping the plant alive because it puts out leaf area, creates photosynthesis and that sort of thing. So, yeah, we're just going to go down the line here. And take a look at all these buds. That one's nice and alive, primary, secondary, tertiary, all still with us. So that's what we want to see. And you just sort of going down through each bud, taking just a little cross section off at a time. That one is also healthy. So we'll get through our 10 buds on this cane, and we'll mark down, how many of the primaries, secondaries, and tertiaries are alive and how many didn't make it. According to the literature, up to 14% primary bud mortality is considered just normal in any given season. If you have anywhere from 14 to 34% primary bud mortality, you're gonna wanna retain, conservatively, you wanna retain 35% additional nodes when you're pruning. And if you have 35% to 50% bud mortality, you're gonna wanna double your retained nodes than what you would have done in a normal season. And if you have over 50% primary bud mortality, typically minimal pruning or no pruning at all is gonna be your best bet.
If you're gonna minimal or no prune, to be conservative and kind of wait and see what the season gets you and you know what kind of fruitfulness you have. A lot of our research into crop load management is really crucial and in these times, because what could happen is, you know, you minimal prune and you end up having, you know, a nice favorable season, a lot of shoots out there, you might get some crowding, you might get, you know, too much crop. So shoot thinning is one of the ways that we have managed that crop early in the season and past this threat of spring frost. Another option, or in tandem, would be to do your crop estimate mid-season and then maybe do some fruit thinning to bring those vines back into balance. So, you know, kind of everything that we're doing here is all connected. And even if you have winter injured vines, you might still need to implement some crop load management practices to make sure that they're not overcropped in the current growing season. As usual, if you have any comments, please leave them in the comments section below, and feel free to reach out to us at lergp.com.